evening. If you please find your seat. We're already a little behind schedule, and that is, it's really my fault, but I'm looking around for somebody else to blame. Everyone will find their seats. We'll get started this evening. This evening, we'll have the posting of the colors by the Hopkins County Military Coalition Color Bar. I'll turn it over to them at this time.
May you all rise as we post the colors. Johnny Rush in and Ricky Roy will be posting the colors for us. Prepare to advance the colors. Forward, march.
It did. When we found out that this was coming, that the protesters were coming, we as a board had a meeting. And we immediately went to the Hopkins County Sheriff's Department, Lewis Tatum, and to Jason Rickerson, the Sulphur Springs Police Department. And then we met with the contestants, their parents, Queen, their parents. We met with everyone involved. They were going to protest against the parade, the milking contest, and the ice cream freeze-off. So everyone that was involved in that, the board met with them. And I will stand today and tell you that the Sulphur Springs Police Department and the Hopkins County Sheriff's Department did an awesome job in protecting us. As a board, we began to pray. We prayed for the activists that were coming. We prayed for protection over all the parade participants. We prayed for God's protection over the Sheriff's Department, over the Police Department. And we especially prayed God's protection over our community. We prayed that He would give us each a sweet spirit, a loving heart, and a welcome to these people. And God answered those prayers and did much more. We saw a community come together and support the very heritage that our community was built on. So tonight I'm going to ask all board members that can come out, some of them are not able to come out, but the ones that are in the audience, to stand and join me at this time.
Welcoming the man who knows more cow jokes, our MC for tonight, Craig.
Greg Roberts.
We're going to have some fun tonight, but we're going to celebrate, and I'm going to see how I can get Carolyn King to just follow me around and read that on a loop. I will say we're not going to get into politics tonight. I do have a lot of jokes. I'm going to spend a little bit of time sharing with the hard work that's been put into this. But I will note one thing. Carolyn brought up the protest. A lot of you saw a lot of things on social media, different things. It doesn't matter. There was one post that I saw by one of their organizers. Someone shared it with me. And they, of course, stated their stance. The one thing they said was that they were welcomed in Hopkins County by the board president, treated with respect by the law enforcement. That tells you who Hopkins County is. Give Hopkins County a round. Welcome to the 60th annual Hopkins County Dairy Festival Pageant. We started celebrating our theme, Over the Moon in Dairyland, as we watched those beautiful hot air balloons glow at dusk on Friday and at dawn and dusk on Saturday. Shannon Oaks Church was the perfect venue once again for the huge, colorful balloons. With a live music and the concessions by the Buford, moving to Shannon Oaks ground during the hot air balloon rally, the Texas State Champion homemade ice cream freeze-off was once again a tremendous success. You might ask, Moon over Dairyland. This marks the 50th year of the lunar landing on the moon. Our famous parade continued our sweep to Junior's Dairy Month last Saturday with over 100 entries and with Queen Caitlin Farrell top for a beautiful logo. We were favored with the appearance of returning royalty, Amy Webb Moffitt celebrating her 25th year of being crowned, Bonnie Booker Kids celebrating her 40th anniversary as Dairy Festival royalty, and Sunil Rogers Comfort celebrating her 60th as our first Dairy Festival queen. Unable to attend was our 10th anniversary queen, Kate Cody Roden, and 50th anniversary queen, Janet Skidmore Casey. We're so pleased that these three former queens were part of our parade. Also, the little kids. They've been amazingly quiet, and that is awesome. Listen to them. They were the perfect moonbeams as they followed on their mini floats, which were very well done, with each pair representing different parties. Their mini floats were judged by an independent panel, and the results will be announced tonight. The parade also included a number of eye-catching floats that were designed and hand-built by commercial businesses and other organizations. These floats were judged on eye appeal, use of theme, and overall quality of workmanship, and those awards will be revealed tonight. Leading the parade, Grand Marshal, I might know her, and she's my friend, Linda Hager, joined by her great-granddaughter, Charlie. Following the parade, we all enjoyed watching the candidates and their parents milking real dairy cows in a hot contest. Thanks again to the Coon family for providing the beautiful turns of cows and lots of milk. The full week of activities included the fun at the carnival and the Junior Dairy Show sponsored by Northeast Texas Junior Livestock Association. Just today, we kicked off our second annual Whip Challenge, a food competition that mimics the popular TV show Chopped. 6 teams of 4 have to incorporate 2 dairy products into soup ingredients to prepare an appetizer, main dish, and dessert. The winning team of the competition was, and I have my notes here, I'll probably get in trouble. I don't have envelopes. I don't even know who was there. Y'all pretend it's frozen right now. Here we go. They didn't get to, but now I'm in trouble. They won it. The milkmaids, the Aguilar sisters won it. Hopkins County. Here we go.
Turn off your cell phones and your flashlights. Sorry, Cindy.
Pager. Somebody's laughing at me on a pager. Aha, I got you. All right, here we go. Please welcome our candidates for Dairy Festival Queen, nine lovely and talented young ladies who will compete this season in casual wear, talent presentation, and evening gown. The interview portion was conducted this afternoon prior to the judges' dinner. These contestants have been very busy working toward the coveted title of Hopkins County Dairy Festival Queen. So don't anyone move. As we welcome you to the 60th Dairy Festival Queen Coronation Pageant.
Thank you.
please greet our candidates for Dairy Festival in 2019. They are delightful and vivacious candidates. Let's give them one more round of applause. And now, your reigning Hopkins County Dairy Festival Queen, Miss Caitlin Farrell. Thank you for welcoming Queen Caitlin for her first appearance this evening. Our Dairy Festival Queen has enjoyed representing us at community appearances and commercial ribbon cuttings to highlight our dairy industry. You have been an excellent ambassador for Hopkins County and our dairy families and businesses. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2018 Hopkins County Dairy Festival Queen, Miss Caitlin Farrell. One of the favorite times, and they have behaved well. This is outstanding. Here come the little kids. They are moonbeams. Let's meet them as they help celebrate our theme this year, Over the Moon in Dairyland, which these kids represent as they rode on the mini float for the parade last Saturday in very big interpretations. Please welcome our first pair of moonbeams, Carly Cox and Barrett Ingram. Carly is the daughter of Cody and Kennedy Cox. Their mini float was looked as the moon landed was today instead of 50 years ago. These two were reaching for the moon. Carly is 3 years old and attends Dolan Company Day School. She participates in ballet and tap at Artist Center for Performing Arts. She enjoys loving on her new sister, Kim, and attends church at First Baptist Church in Sulphur Springs. Barrett is the son of Preston and Lauren Ingram. He enjoys camping, canoeing, fishing, and imitating Ferdinand, the bull. And Johnny from Singing, he attends Dolan Company Day School as well. Ladies and gentlemen, Carly Cox and Barrett Ingram. Team 2 took a spin-off from a famous Christmas movie, but changing it to It's a Wonderful Dairy Life. Every time you hear a cowbell, a cow gets its wings. Conrad and Mia recap the parts, George and Mary, to the tune of Buffalo Gals. Mia Irby and Conrad Rudyot did not go away with a spoon. Mia is the daughter of Brian and Lucinia Diasado. She attends Annika's preschool and is 6 years old. She enjoys spending time with family and going on outdoor adventures. She loves ballet and animals. She hopes to be a veterinarian someday. Conrad is 3.5 years old, son of Vinny and Cassie Mandiot, and attends Annika's Montessori school. Since his parents own dairy, Conrad enjoys spending time on the track with his dad and being around the cattle. When he's not farming, he likes to watch Paw Patrol and swim. He knows how to count in three languages: English, Dutch, and Spanish. Conrad hates pickles, but loves to dip his french fries in mayo. Thank you, Mia and Conrad. Don't get sleepy on this terrific duo. The theme for their float was Good Night Moon, a popular bedtime story. Brooklyn Durang and Bentley Major. Let's get back to the other duo down the parade route. Brooklyn is the daughter of Ian and Jesse Durang. She is 3.5 years old and attends Little Lake School. Brooklyn is a good combination of tomboy and girly girl. She likes to dress up and also ride horses. She enjoys swimming and loves doting on baby brother Everett. Bentley is the son of Aaron and Jill Major, and he is 3.5 years old. He also goes to Little Acre School. Bentley likes to play outside with his family and wants to be a farmer when he grows up. He likes to play with his older brother Scott, and his favorite person is his grandma. Thank you, Brooklyn and Bentley.
had many floats were absolutely moved. The judges for this group had a hard job, but they finally narrowed it down. Here we go. Caitlin, are you ready? Third place, Moonbeams. Theme, Hey Bill Bill. Mia Irby, daughter of Brian Yacine Asada. Conrad Runyot, son of Benny and Cassie Manuel.
Right now, though, sit back and enjoy Mike and his backup singers.
wife Kristen, and daughters Cassidy and Kenna, as they entertain you with Country Roads, a hit made popular by John Denver.
Good evening, y'all. Happy to be here with you this evening. We're going to continue the space theme with a song called Country Roads.
Almost in West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountain, Shenandoah River. Life is old there. Older than the trees, younger than the mountains, flowing like a breeze. Country roads take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, my mama, take me home. Country roads, all my memories gather round her, miner's lady, stranger to the water. Dark and dusty, painted on the sky, misty taste of moonshine, teardrop in my eyes. Country roads, take me home to the place I belong.
He holds a Bachelor of Arts in English. history and a Master of Arts in English from Stephen F. Austin University. He published a book of children's poetry, has directed over 85 major productions, and has the pleasure of recording an album of original songs in Nashville. In his spare time, he writes weekly columns for East Texas Press and serves as pianist in his church. He just completed his 30th year of teaching, during which he has taught everything from literature to history to singing to acting theory to theatrical makeup. He is currently employed at Rands ISD and lives near Emory. Welcome to Hopkins County, Christopher Collins. Sierra Ramon is a corporate professional by day and is a faculty member of the Academy of Dance, Music, and Theater in Greenville by evening. She's an award-winning choreographer and directs the Northeast Texas Dance Company at her academy. Her commitment to technical excellence has helped her students take on top honors from competitions including multiple high-point and Judge Choice Awards and scholarships. Each day, Sierra strives to uphold her academy's core value of setting the stage for a lifetime. She believes that through the arts, students develop confidence, integrity, teamwork, dedication, and leadership skills that will serve them through their lifetime. Sierra is a graduate of Oklahoma State University and holds a Master of Business Administration from Texas A&M Commerce. Thank you for joining us, Sierra Ramon. Bill Wheeler has a background heavy in education. He taught in public schools for 49 years, with emphasis on band, choir, art, and theater. Bill has kept the love of fine arts alive by performing with the Sherman Community Theater, Grayson Community Choir, Austin College Theater Department, Villagers Chorale, and at the Sherman Arts Fest. He has served on various boards in his community, including Sherman's Girls Club, Sherman Community Players, Sherman Musical Arts, the Chamber of Commerce, Grayson Cancer Association, and the Sherman Preservation League. Bill is an ordained ruling elder for his church. For 30 years, he served as choir director at the Presbyterian church he attends. He is a graduate of Texas Christian University and holds a degree in music education. Bill is married to Sandra for 49 years and has one son, Kent, and one grandson, Holden. Thank you for coming, Bill Wheeler. Nikki Silva is a theater director and debate teacher at Denison High School. She holds a Master of Arts degree in drama with an emphasis on acting and directing from Texas Women's University. She has directed over 50 productions and coached multiple Best Actor and Best Actress UIL One Act Play Award winners. She was part of the theatrical troupe that directed and performed original works of theater in Prague, the Czech Republic, during a 3-week international theatrical tour. She had been singing and performing since the age of 5. Nikki believes that all things are possible if you have strong faith, believe in yourself, and aren't afraid to be told no. She works hard and instills her students each and every day. In her spare time, Miss Silva is a loving foster mother and loves to travel, cook, and love her 2 fur babies. She enjoys spending time with her wonderful mother and best friends. She's excited to be part of this long-standing tradition for the first time. We're happy to have you here, Miss Nikki Silva. Stephen Janway comes to us from Collin County. Stephen and his husband Robert call McKinney home. Steve spends his days maintaining a district court docket and holds certification in court management. He has worked for Collin County for 4 years as the court administrator. He was involved in community theater for 7 years. During his tenure, he directed and acted in many shows, including Annie Jr., The Marvelous Wonderettes, Nunsit, The Butler Did It, Singing, and Murder for Rent. He has also coached several young ladies for pageants. He and Robin enjoy going to Disney World, cruising the Caribbean, running 5Ks, and are planning a trip to Italy next year. They are busy parents to a teenage son, David. Welcome back to Hopkins County, Stephen Janway. I'd like to hit the lights one more time because I'm not going to forget her. Thank you, judges. But for our auditor, we issue Miss Emily Glass. We thank you for your dedication to the staff. The talent presentation is the most entertaining part of our pageant. We will see the result of ability, training, and hours of practicing on the part of each of our candidates. This showcases each one's capability
and their individuality. Contestant number one, Katie Brown, is performing a tap dance to the iconic World War II song made popular by the Andrews Sisters in 1941, Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number one, Miss Katie Brown. Remember, I will give you credit, so watch what you text me. should you tell a secret on a farm? Because the potatoes have eyes and the corn has ears. Come on now. We're expanding from the cow jokes this year. Wait, I want to see my comment. Wait a minute. I got an astronaut joke. This is an easy one. What's an astronaut's favorite place on a computer? Space bar. Here you go. What time do astronauts eat? At launch time. I'm telling you, it's not going to get better. So, that's what gets it. So that's what I need. Ladies and gentlemen, don't take your eyes off contestant number two, Carol Neighbors, as she entertains you with her sliding hand magic showcase. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number two, Carol Neighbors. Join me in welcoming the parents of contestant number seven, Anne Marie Gunn, that was Jay and Don Looney, and Brandon and Amanda Gunn.
You, and if that's all that we need to do, and
ladies and gentlemen, candidate number three, Miss Sadie Connor.
Thank you.
successful participating in our dairy festival. Let's welcome the parents of contestant number 6, Paul and Jill Harvey. Please meet the parents of contestant number 5, Ashlyn Beverly, John and Katie Beverly. And at this time, we're about to begin the show. I'd like to thank Brian and Natalie White for the use of their moon buggy. It says here you guys moon rock. But really, I need to go back and say at this time, I'd like to thank Natalie White, because I don't think she's still running. And that had a top on it before it got here. And it wasn't that color. So don't send pictures to Brian, because I'll tell you. We'll get back together. Thoroughly Modern Millie tells the story of a small-town girl who comes to New York City to marry for money instead of love. Contestant number 5, Ashlyn Beverly, will entertain you now with a jazz routine to forget about the war. From the stupidest model. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 5, Miss Ashlyn Beverly.
So, let's meet some more parents. Let's meet the parents of contestant number four, Sable Erdmeyer, Jesse Young, and Brandon Erdmeyer. Where are they? And join me in welcoming the parents of Sage Connor, contestant number three, Todd and Leah Connor. Last Saturday, the contestants and their parents competed in the annual milking contest in the Civic Center Arena. Winners are awarded trophies, though the results do not figure in tonight's added results. Contestant number two, Carol Neighbors, walked away with the top prize with a whopping 72 ounces of milk. Contestant number eight placed second with 41.6 ounces. And close behind was contestant number three, Sadie Connor. Now the parents moved in for their turn. Brandon and Amanda Gunn, parents of Anne-Marie Gunn, tipped the scales at 41.3 ounces. Melissa Weeks and Jason Goldsmith, parents of Madison Norton, came in second with a respectful 38.5 ounces. And the parents of Rachel Brandon, Mark and Brandon Boat, since third place, was 38.4. So I've got that anyway, 38.5, 38.4. Some of our hot air balloon pilots joined in on the fun. Jim Williams, crew, placed first and promised to return again next year to claim his title. For the past several years, Chris Boone and his family provided the cows for our milking contest. This is a huge task and sacrifice for the Boone family and the herd. We're so appreciative that they support us as they do. A big thank you to Boone for making the milking contest a huge success every year. Contestant number six, Callie Harvey, will be painting to the music Whom Shall I Fear by Christian contemporary artist Chris Tomlin. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number six, Miss Callie Harvey.
Feels the night, it cannot hide the light.
but she has so many friends. This one's from Anna Macy Williams. How does a cow get to the moon? She flies through utter space. See here. Mr. Chandler Armstrong, you're out there, aren't you? Why are cows so good at math? They love to count. I won't get better. That was awesome, Chandler. Keep them coming. Contestant number 7, Miss Anne-Marie Dunham, will be wowing you with her singing and tap dancing to the long-standing Broadway musical, Sweet Charity, Number If They Could See Me Now. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 7, Miss Anne-Marie Dunham.
Let's see here.
What do you call a cow with no legs?
Ground beef. Eddie Schultz.
Let's see here. I'm gonna read this one first. Sorry, Tucker. I heard you all the way up here. How do cherry farmers do their taxes? The simple returns just need a calculator. The more complicated ones need to see an accountant. Robert Cody might be past his bedtime. Holly Reagan, what do you call a cow that doesn't give milk? Milk bud.
Should be a
immune to everything. I swear I'm going to turn them into science. I'm sure to win the Nobel Peace Prize. I'd kill two birds with one stone. One, getting the Nobel Peace Prize, of course, and two, getting rid of my brother. My last story I'll share with y'all is my experience with the Dairy Festival. From the time I can remember, my nanny and I would go to every event the Dairy Festival had. Our top two faves, the milking contest, and, well, of course, the pageant. We've also enjoyed Mr. Roberts' joke throughout the year, so, Mr. Roberts, I've been taking notes, and I hope this isn't too cheesy. I've been working on my milking since I entered the pageant, and I can honestly say it's been utter chaos. Who knew cows get so much? My mom and all would not stop laughing at me, but I didn't find it amusing. But me being so competitive, I knew the stakes were high. Now looking back, I can honestly say, if cows could have giggled, they'd have been a laughing stock. Thank y'all. Good night.
Grace and evidence. Grace and elegance? That's me to a T. Kevin. And Felicia.
So please stand for the show of appreciation with a round of applause, our dairy families. At intermission, I met a very, I had like a note, but I met a very nice gentleman who was actually on the, he was actually chairman of the Miss Texas pageant, chairman of the board. And he complimented me on the acts that were here tonight and said this is an outstanding presentation. As I visited with him though, his wife is Betty Arnold Dodd. The Harold Arnold had a GE appliance store here many years ago. They now live in Dallas, but the one thing he wanted to do was congratulate me, congratulate the staff, and he also made a donation tonight to the pageants. Give him a round of applause. At this time, many of you know that have served as a parade grand marshal, and tonight we have this year's grand marshal, she better come out, Linda Hager with us. Linda, can you please step out from backstage? Stay out here, Mom. Keep waving. My first day in Hopkins County, April 2001, she took me to meet Billy Sam Elliott, who was the chamber director at that time, to explain to me what my involvement needed to be in the town. It worked. Thank you, Linda. We also have many talented and lovely young ladies in our area, and we'd like to meet and welcome any ranking royalty who represent their community. So if the House likes to come back up, if there's any royalty from other communities. All right. At this time, the Board of Directors would like to personally acknowledge the family of our reigning queen, Miss Caitlin Farrell. Would Queen Caitlin's parents, Jeremy and Christy Farrell, please stand and be recognized? Please sit back and enjoy Queen Caitlin as she entertains you with a flute piece, La Flute de Pas, by Mal K. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Caitlin Farrell.
As a part-time teller, and I've been getting ready for this.
Exactly.
right? That loud of flowers and crow. You're gonna be nervous when you do that?
Yes.
What's your favorite piece to play? Is it something cool with you?
I like some pieces I played last year for Gary Christmas.
Really? I'm gonna get in trouble for this. Play me like 3 bars.
3 bars?
4 bars? I don't know what this is. That's okay. Please laugh now. It's all because you're good now.
Festival has been a great experience and one that I will surely never forget. One thing that I have come to realize is life is too short for stress and to have insecurities. There is much pride and possibilities for each and every one of us if we use the potential that God gave us. Before I close, I would like to thank our local and non-local dairy farmers, my close family and friends, Chanel Mahega for helping me backstage, and of course, my amazing parents for all that they do and the support that they give. Thank you.
Carol Neighbors, contestant 2, is a senior at Cumble Picton High School. She is 18 years old and has blue eyes and brown hair. Carol's hobbies include showing pigs and cheerleading. She is in the top 10 of the class and stays busy as cheer captain. She's in Future Farmers of America, FCCLA, and National Honor Society. One of her highlights of the Dairy Festival this week was milking a cow in the milking contest. After graduation, Carol would like to attend Northeast Texas Community College to become a physical therapist assistant. Tonight, Carol entertains you with a magic showcase. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 2, Miss Carol Neighbors. Candidate number 3, Miss Sadie Connor. Sadie's escort this evening by her dad, Dr. Tom Connor.
As you heard from the incredible Craig Roberts, I'm contestant number 3, Sadie Connor. Growing up, I was always taught to love, take the high road, and be faithful. I'd like to thank my parents for the endless hours dedicated to such an important event in Hopkins County. To my grandparents, thank you for teaching me the importance of the dairy industry and the constant encouragement. To the rest of my family, thank you so very much for the endless support. Michael, I love you so very much. Thank you for everything you've done for me throughout this process. Both of us may leave with the win tonight, but I know for sure you will. You meet this thing once, and you'll do it again.
Participates in Beta Club, UIL, and FCCLA. She volunteers for community theater, Bright Star Baseball, Sulphur Springs Work Camp, and Texified Jam Fest. She received the 2019 Yearbook Award, the most likely to be heard. Sadie enjoys volleyball, basketball, swimming, singing, drawing, and makeup. At school, she's an all-honor student and participates in music memory, persuasive speaking, and the cupcake battle. She has special training from volleyball clinics and camps, theater workshops, and vocal training. Sadie's favorite part of the festival has been rehearsals because she's enjoyed seeing everyone improve each night. Her future plans are to attend nursing school to become a CRNA. Tonight, Sadie entertains you with Only Us from the Broadway musical, Dear Evan Hansen. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 3, Miss Sadie Connor. Miss Sable Erdmeyer. She is escorted this evening by her grandfather, Mr. Tom Young.
Thank you.
16-year-old, blue-gray-eyed, red-haired beauty. She is currently in training for powerlifting and future EMT and dispatching classes. Her special interests include volleyball, track, cheerleading, and powerlifting. Sable was a regional qualifier in powerlifting, placing fourth and placed first in discus in the 2019 pre-district meet. She's been nominated for All-American Cheerleader and was named 2019 MVP of the Year in powerlifting. Asked what was her favorite part of the festival this week? The parade. It's been her favorite part because she loves seeing the smiles on the faces of children. Tonight, Sable wowed you with a monologue with a video and impressed us with her powerlifting. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number four, Miss Sable Erdmeyer. Candidate number five, Miss Ashlyn Bimmerly. Supporting Ashlyn is her dad, John Bimmerly.
Good evening. My name is Ashlyn Bimmerly, and I'm contestant number five. Helen Keller once said, "Alone we can do so little, together we can do so much." This quote made me think about the support that the people of Hopkins County have shown me throughout the Dairy Festival. This experience has introduced me to so many new people, and I feel honored to participate in such an event. Thank you.
Ashlyn is from Silver Springs High School and will be a senior. She has trained in dance for 14 years and has been on a competitive team many of those years. At school, Ashlyn was recently elected Vice President of the National Honor Society. She is on the Student Council, in Key Club, Health Science Technology, and is in practicum where she learns about the medical field. Her hobbies include participating in community events, teaching dance to younger students, and spending time with her friends. Her favorite part of the festival has been getting to see Sulphur Springs while riding in a hot air balloon. After graduation, she plans to go to college to become a pediatric nurse practitioner. During the talent portion this evening, Ashlyn sang "Forget About the Boy" from the musical Thoroughly Modern Millie. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number five, Miss Ashlyn Bimmerly. Candidate number six, Miss Kelly Harvey. Kelly is escorted this evening by her father, Paul Harvey. Honor roll at school and also has perfect attendance. She She volunteers for Teen Court and at Broadway Hospital in the summer. Callie's favorite part of this week's festival has been making new friends with the other contestants and gaining confidence in herself. In tonight's talent portion, Callie walked us through the steps of painting, with the finished product being a brown Swiss cow. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 6, Miss Callie Harvey.
Tonight's talent portion, Madison brought a smile to our faces with her true to life
stand-up comedy routine. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 8, Miss Madison Norton. Contestant number 9, Miss Rachel Bramlett. Escorting Rachel is her brother, Spencer Bramlett. Makes her final walk.
Good evening. Thank you all for attending tonight. I believe that this has been the best year I could have asked for. I'd like to thank the Dairy Festival Board, my family, and all the other amazing people who have been involved throughout this journey. Thank you to the board for considering my every question and coming up with a solution promptly, and for being so welcoming and kind to me and my family. I'm so grateful for everything you have done for this festival. Thank you to my mom for putting her all into ensuring that every event was planned thoroughly and every dress was steamed to perfection. Thank you to my dad for always making room in his chaotic schedule to help me with a new project, whether that be building a flow or being present at events. Thank you to my sister for being observant of me. You remind me to be a role model to those who may look up to me, and it's my wish that I've been a good one for you. Also, you will be a contestant soon, so buckle up and enjoy the ride. And finally, thank you to everyone who has loved and supported me every step of the way. Y'all are the reason I am in this position today. I'm beyond blessed with the opportunity to have served as a Hopkins County Dairy Festival Queen for 2018, and would like to wish the future queen the best. To the next queen, never forget to love those around you with a childlike love and serve others whenever you get the chance to. I know you will make an amazing queen and have a great year. Remember to enjoy every single moment of it because it'll be over before you know it. For the last time, I'm Caitlin Farrell and I'm your Hopkins County Dairy Festival Queen for 2018.
Thank you again, Caitlin, for joining us this year. We express our gratitude for your financial support this past year. The Board of Directors would like to express their appreciation for our local sponsors who are always so very generous in their support of our festival, and especially the hot air balloons. The propane place in Charles Aston is full 100% of fuel for the balloons. And also please note the merchants and businesses who generously donated over $2,500. Please look for these contributors are listed in your program and take a minute to read them and thank them for their support. While all the judges' votes are being tallied, please welcome back to the stage Michael Branch and Craig Roberts to do a duet. Making sure y'all are here, just making sure you're still listening. Come on, Michael, he will perform his original, kind of sort of original piece, The Anakin Saga. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Michael Branch.
You're not going to join me?
Which part did I get?
There's a lot of tension up here on this stage. Doing? I'm just kidding. I know I'm here. I'm here because there's nothing better to help these ladies relax a little bit and lower the tension than feeling sorry for someone else. So, I'm here to lower the bar. Little self-deprecating humor there, but this would be even funnier. It's funny because it's true. I was having a conversation the other day on the phone, and I was telling them about this, and me being the entertainment and all that for this deal, and they said, you? And I said, yeah. And they said, I don't see it. This is a true story. And I said, they said, well, I mean, your wife, she's very, very talented. But you, do you play the guitar a little bit or something? And I said, geez, Mom. That's harsh. Your parents are supposed to be your biggest fans, you know. they did tell me when I first was approached about this, I was like, what are the qualifications of actually being the entertainment for the deal? And she said, well, all the contestants are female, so they really want a male. Talk about a confidence booster. I'm like, yes, the one qualification. I got that handled. I'll tell you a little bit about it. Strangely enough, it works out with the whole space, the moon theme and all. How many of you out there like Star Wars? Do we have any Star Wars fans out there? I love Star Wars. I watched Star Wars the first time when I was probably about 5 or 6 years old. And this song is actually a spoof of a spoof. It was written by a genius lyricist by the name of Weird Al Yankovic, okay? And he was spoofing, of course, the old, you know, Bye Bye, Miss American Pie song, and it was great, but it was only about episode one, and I wanted to write a song that kind of combined all three episodes. And so this is what I call the Anakin Saga. And this is the part where they get to feel sorry for me because the song, either you're going to feel sorry for me or you're going to feel bad or sad about the song. So I hope you really enjoy this, the Anakin song. A long, long time ago, in a galaxy far away, that was under an attack. And I thought me and Qui-Gon talk the Federation into maybe cutting them a little slack. But war broke out and Gungans died. Some ships blew up and pilots fried. A lot of boats were broken. The battle droids were broken. And the Jedi I admire most met up with Darth Maul and now he's toast. I'm still here and he's a ghost. I had to train the boy. My, that there Anakin guy turned to Vader sometime later. He was such a great guy. He left his home and kissed his mama goodbye and soon became a famous Jedi. Yeah, he's the most famous Jedi. Well, and he did what he always do. He worked real hard and it also grew. And he learned to use the Force. His job was to protect the king. And anybody could have seen that he'd fall in love with her. Someday, of course. But his mother died and he went medieval. He hunted down and killed sand people. He was infuriated. It really escalated. Well, we joined with clones and we fought the droids. And he took them down like children's toys. The Jedi, we were overjoyed. I'm glad I trained this boy. Singing my, that there Anakin guy turned to Vader sometime later. He's such a great guy. He left his home and kissed his mama goodbye and soon became a famous Jedi. Yeah, he's the most famous Jedi. Well, the war raged on among the stars and everyone was battle scarred, but Annie, oh, he gave in to his fear. He was afraid to lose his wife. The worst mistake of his whole life would cause him to lose all that he held dear. His anger tore our worlds apart. I took him down on Mustafar. I believe that he chosen, but still my heart is broken. This Jedi I had called my friend, I brought to his bitter end.
darkness, he began again. Why I trained the boy, singing by and by at their end, and got turned to bed sometime later. He was such a brave guy. He left his home and kissed his mama goodbye, and soon became a famous Jedi. Yeah, he's the most famous Jedi. My, my, that there energy guy turned to bed sometime later. He was such a great guy. He left his home and kissed his mama goodbye, and soon became a famous Jedi. Yeah, he's the most famous Jedi.
I have one more song. I can maybe squeeze you in a little. Would you guys like to hear another song? In that case, I want to bring my beautiful wife and my two beautiful daughters out to sing with me. All right, so my whole thing is, we did the first song, and it was a John Denver song, Country Roads, and it was one of the very first songs I remember singing as a kid at school in choir, and I've always been a fan of John Denver, and then of course Star Wars. I'm a huge fan of Star Wars. And then the third song I wrote right here in Sulphur Springs when I was about 18, 19 years old, and it's called Sincerely Clark, and the song is about Superman. And the whole point of the song is to tug at your heartstrings and make you think about Superman in a way that you never have before. So this song is called Sincerely Clark. I hope you enjoy it. Flew around the world today, had some things to do anyway, saved all of mankind from all out war. Blew out a fire in Beijing. That was really no big thing. And now I wonder who I did it for. I can tell a locomotive apart, but I can't break into your heart. Now the man in the red and yellow got the blue. Will I miss him, do you miss Lane? Sometimes you don't even know my name. If only you knew I'm the man blue, things would probably turn out alright. Now the man of steel got a broken heart tonight. They all call me the man of steel, but they don't know how I really feel. I can be hurt just the same. And I may be the son of Krypton, but my heart can still be stepped on. Superman still feels the pain. I'd rather pack my bags and fly back home than to face in the night in this world alone. You know I'd give my strength just to live my life with you. Will I may seem plain to you, Miss Lane? Sometimes you don't even know my name. If only you knew I'm the man blue, things would probably turn out alright. Now the man of steel, a broken heart tonight. All you see is the hero you need. You don't even know who I am. It's my destiny to save humanity, so I'll just smile and fly out of sight. But I've still got a broken heart. I'm still a broken.
Caitlin, would you please come forward to help with the awards? Each year, the contestants help support the Dairy Festival by participating in a ticket sales competition. The winners receive monetary awards. However, the results do not figure into the Queen competition and coronation results. We do appreciate our candidates' participation in the ticket sales each year. Second place in ticket sales. Hopkins County Dairy Festival second place ticket sales 2019 sold 177 tickets. $1,416, and that is contestant number seven, Miss Anne Marie Gunn. $2,480. Contestant number eight, Ms. Madison Morgan. Also, each year at the interview session, contestants vote by secret ballot for the selection of Miss Congeniality. Today, the candidates vote on the girl that they consider to be the most sincere, kind, and helpful. And that thing is... Let's slow down the big print, read it right on, vote. There you go. Match them up. Miss Congeniality 2019 is contestant number five, Miss Ashley Worthy. Hopkins County Dairy Festival first runner-up 2019. First runner-up. Contestant number 8, Miss Madison Morgan. And now, your new Hopkins County Dairy Festival Queen 2019. Contestant number 9.
Thank you. What's going on through your mind right now?
I'm really excited for her. She's going to do a great job. Rachel's a really good person, and she deserved it. And, I mean, I'm kind of sad because I'm not queen anymore, but she'll do a good job. She'll carry it on very well.
No, your name will be forever in the history.
That's right.
Dairy Festival. You will never be forgotten. You'll be coming back in 10 years to get your picture. You'll be coming back in 50 years as a 50-year queen.
I'll make sure of it. I'll come back.
Has it been an overall fun experience for you?
Yes, I would recommend it to anybody who was interested or wasn't interested.
Carolyn, or I should say, in this capacity, Madam President, what do you think about it?
It's great. All the girls were just awesome. It was kind of hard for us backstage to decide who's going to win, but we're thrilled with who's going to be the queen. We look forward to working with her and her parents. But again, all the girls did an awesome job. I believe it was the best dairy festival that we've ever had. We went out on the 60th anniversary with a big, huge bite. And thank you, Doug, for all you did.
All I was going to say is, how are we possibly going to top this?
That is correct. I just don't know. But see, I won't be Madam President next year. Someone else gets to do it.
Oh, who do I get
McKay,
to pick out?
David McCain is our Vice President this year, so he gets to take the reins.
Thank you so much.
The President's already ratted you out.
Uh-oh.
As she has stepped down as of tonight, and you are the new president.
That is true. That is true.
Okay, my question is, how are we going to top this next year?
I relegate a lot of assignments, so I will delegate a lot of things to people, you know, and then we'll go from there.
So you're going to be on the phone saying, Carolyn?
Yep, that's exactly right. Yep.
All right, looking forward to it, sir.
I am too.
Do I got anything to say about it?
The great pageant, the great festival. We're ready for next year.
Just mash Gracie out of the way.
Squish me.
Brenda, I'm easily pushed.
So,
yeah. It's hard to keep you in the shot when you keep moving around.
No shots.
All right, what's connection here?
Lexi, my daughter.
Yes.
Is in Spencer. Girlfriend, and then Spencer is Rachel's sister. So that's where it is.
Okay, there we go. It all makes sense now. How many daughters do you have?
Three.
So you only have to do this three more times.
Get to the cheering! Let's go! Is this better?
Much better. Thank you.